न्यूरल कंडक्शन एंड ट्रांसमिशन. द सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम इज मेड अप ऑफ टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स, ग्लियल सेल्स एंड न्यूरॉन्स. द वर्ड ग्लियल इज डिराइव फ्रॉम द ग्रीक वर्ड विच इज मेंट ग्लू. Glial cells serve the primary function of holding the central nervous system together, and they provide structural support to central nervous system. Neurons are the second type of cells, and these are the cells that process and transmit information through the nervous system within the brain. So neurons primarily serve three actions: they receive, integrate, and generate the sensory input and divert into the messages. Now, what is the actual number of neurons in the brain? It is estimated that there are approximately 10 billion nervous neurons in human brain. And the connection of neurons, which have approximately 10,000 connections to other neurons, making for trillions and trillions of neural connections in human brain. And this was concluded on the study of Hyman 2005. Neurons basically serve following functions. They are known as the building blocks of nervous system. All the major structures of the brain are composed of neurons. Information travels within a neuron in the form of an electrical signal by action potential. And information is transmitted between neurons by means of chemicals called neurotransmitters. Now, what is the structure of a neuron? The structure of neuron, it was Raymond Y. Cagle who identified the three major parts of the neurons. First is cell body, dendrites and axons. In this picture, you can clearly visualize the structure of neurons. This part is cell body of the neuron. This is the axon and the fatty shield. This is called the myelin sheath. These tips are the axon terminals and these tips are the dendrites. Cell body or soma contains a nucleus and other components needed for cell maintenance and function. While axon extending from the soma is a long projection called the axon, which transmits electrical impulses toward the adjacent neuron. While dendrites on the other hand, on the other side of the soma are the dendrites. These are the finger-like projections that receive incoming message from other neurons. Now, what is myelin sheath? It is the fatty substance wrapped around some axons, which insulates the axon, making the nerve impulse travel more efficiently. And one more thing is very important here, and this is synapse. What is synapse? It is the junction between the axon and the adjacent neuron is known as the synapse. And terminal buttons at the end of the axons at each synapse is a terminal button containing tiny sacs of transmitter. And when an electrical impulse reaches the terminal button, it triggers the release of neurotransmitter molecules into gap between neurons, which is known as the synaptic cleft. Now, you can understand the whole process by this diagram more clearly. This is the neuron cell body. This is the nucleus. These are the synapses. This is the axon. Nucleus, these are the two neurons. This is the electrical signal which is going in this particular direction, and these are the dendrites of the next neuron. Now, there are different types of neurons. One is known as the sensory neurons, which receive incoming sensory information from the sense organ, and sensory input is taken to the brain for processing. Motor neurons take commands from the brain and carry them to the muscles of the body. Each time we move any muscles, motor neurons are at work. In other words, we can say whatever sensory input is received by our brain is through our sensory neurons. And after processing that sensory input, the neurons get activated and they give command to the motor neurons. And these motor neurons take command from the brain and carry them to the muscles of the body. Third type of neurons are the mirror neurons. These are the motor neurons that are active when monkeys observe other performing an action, as well as when the monkey itself undertakes the same action. It plays important role in learning. Fourth are the interneurons. These are the neurons that communicate only with other neurons. These are the three types of neurons. This is the sensory neurons. It is taking the sensory input to the neurons. It travels into this direction from the left to the right direction. And then these are the interneurons, and from here the impulses are traveling from right to left direction. These are the motor neurons, which are carrying the command from the brain to the muscles of the body. These are the structures of different type of neurons: motor neurons, interneurons and sensory neurons. Now, neural connections, communications is a two-step process. First step is an impulse travels one way from dendrite along the axon and away from the soma, a process that is both electrical and chemical. It is also known as the action potential. And the second step is that the impulse releases chemicals at the end of the neurons, which are released into the synaptic cleft to transmit the message to another neurons, known as the neurotransmission. Now, we should understand the action potential. It is the positively charged impulse that moves down an axon. This happens by virtue of change in neurons itself. Membranes move around the neurons. These are the neurons, and all the membranes move around the neurons. This membrane is somewhat permeable, which means that it lets only certain particles move through it. The fluid inside and outside the cell contains electrically charged particles called ions. And these ions are sodium ions positively charged, potassium ions positively charged, and chloride ions negatively charged. Channels in the membrane of the neuron allow ions to flow between the inside and outside of the cell. Some of these channels are always open. Other are called voltage dependent channels, open only when certain electrical conditions are met. That is why these are known as the voltage dependent channels. Now, what is resting potential? In the resting potential, or in the resting state, there is an excess of negatively charged particle inside the axon. The fluid outside the axon has a positive charge. This charge difference between the inside and outside is known as potential. When a neuron is at rest, the charge difference between the inside and outside the axon is -70. This value is the resting potential of neuronal membrane. When the neuron is returning to its resting state, it temporarily becomes super negatively charged. And during this brief period, known as the refraction period, the neurons cannot generate another action.